Good morning, everyone. Sweet Money here, and welcome back to another episode of Hack My Labor, the Starbase tutorial series where we turn your starter laborer into something your family would be proud of. Today, we're going to be making one of the last necessary upgrades to our power systems by adding more generator power. We'll also be able to adjust our new YOLOL generator script to accommodate the extra power. Before we begin, as always, hit the like button if you've been enjoying this series and subscribe so you don't miss the next one. I read and respond to all your comments, so leave a comment with any questions you might have or suggestions for an upgrade you haven't seen yet. If you want to watch me tinker with my labor live on Twitch, I stream every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday, so follow me there. All right, let's get to work. Putting together some extra generators shouldn't be too complicated, but finding space in this ship is beginning to be an issue. Underneath our ship, we have a pretty nice chunk of real estate if we move these radiators, so let's start there. Get out your trusty bolt tool and just remove all the bolts from each section of these center radiators. Make sure you have enough room in your inventory to pick them up since we'll be needing these later. Just a quick tip, you can transfer things from your backpack to your station inventory and vice versa by double-clicking them. It's one of those many things that the game doesn't tell you about but ends up being super useful to know. We need to unbolt these hardpoints and stash them away for later as well. Next, we need to remove a large chunk of this plating and fill it in again as we go. To get started, the bottom of your ship should look something like this. We left the sidemost 192 by 192 plates, but stripped everything from the front of the ship back to the ISAN receivers. You should be good if the bottom of your ship looks like this. Go ahead and aim at the bottom of your ship and press Q to reorient yourself if it's more comfortable for you to work right side up. Let's do some crafting now. We're going to need 12 96 by 96 centimeter basic plates. We'll also use 6 192 by 192 centimeter plates, but you should have most of those from what we just removed. Go ahead and craft any extras you might need. As for our generators, we're not going small. Craft yourself 4 generator fuel chamber tier 1, 12 generator unit tier 1, 2 generator socket board, and 2 generator pipe socket board. We're going to start by filling in the front and back of this opening with 96 by 96 centimeter plates. You can auto bolt these down if you wish, but auto bolting plates usually results in a mess of bolts in random spots. It gets the job done though, if you aren't worried about how the bolts look. We'll add 2 rows of 3 192 by 192 centimeter plates and bolt these down as well. I went with a line of bolts along the beams, but you're free to auto bolt these down again if you want. The next step feels weird, but for the sake of this tutorial, I felt this was the easiest way to get the spacing right. We're going to remove the 4 corner 96 by 96 plates for the time being. This will help us line up the generators just right. Now we can place our generator fuel chambers. You'll want to align the opening where the fuel rod will go with the 96 by 96 centimeter plate we just removed from each corner. Place all 4 fuel chambers and then auto bolt them down. The mouth of each fuel chamber should align and snap right to the edge of the 192 by 192 centimeter plate it's sitting on. Generators are assembled by placing a fuel chamber and then placing a number of generator units connected to it. A single fuel chamber can support up to 3 generator units, which is why we're using 4 fuel chambers and 12 generator units. You can get more fuel and heat efficiency with higher tier generator components, but tier 1 components are only compatible with other tier 1 generator components. All fuel chambers and generator units are the same size, so upgrading to tier 2 is an easy drop-in replacement if we decide to upgrade later. Now we can place the last 2 192 by 192 centimeter plates along the edges, so we'll just have a single hole in the middle left over. Let's go ahead and place our 12 generator units now. Since generators and fuel chambers generate extra heat when they're adjacent to each other, I'm leaving this space in the middle to save a little bit there. You can make this more compact at the cost of heat generation, but we have the room, so spacing it out will be good. Go ahead and auto bolt all of these generator units down. There are a lot of bolts involved here, so they take a minute to finish. Also, make sure to auto bolt your fuel chambers one more time, as you'll likely get a few new bolts into the generator units next to them. Now that everything's bolted down, you can replace the 96 by 96 centimeter plates in the corners as well. There's only one thing left to do to make these generators technically functional. We need to run cable and pipe from them to our network. Lucky for us, we have some ducts sticking out right in the middle here that will make a perfect connection point. Let's unbolt and remove the one L-shaped duct sticking out on each side for now. We'll extend that remaining duct piece when we're ready to connect to it. In order to connect these generators to cable and pipes, we're going to need to attach the sockets we crafted earlier. Place a generator pipe socket board and generator socket board on each set of generators. Since each side of generator units are touching, we only need one socket for each set of generators. Auto bolt these down to secure them. Now we can extend the tiny duct piece left over by running a 144 centimeter piece of duct along the inside of each of these beams. Make sure the duct is as far against the crossbeam as it can be. Ducts transfer their cable and pipe connections as long as they're touching another duct, so this duct will be touching the small piece that's coming through the floor. Remember to auto bolt these pieces down and we're ready to run cable and pipe. Run a single cable from the red socket board and connect it to the duct that we just bolted in. Then run another pipe from the yellow socket board and connect it to the same duct. Repeat this for the other side and these guys are ready to run. Craft 4 tier 1 fuel rods, or just buy them super cheap from the auction house and insert one into each fuel chamber. While we're down here, we can rename all of our fuel chambers to match our original generator. Pull out your universal tool in data mode while hovering over any of the fuel chambers and rename fuel chamber unit rate limit to GM. Do this for all of our new fuel chambers. At this point, if you forgot to turn off your generator, you can do that now if you're worried about the 100% heat on your dashboard. The generators don't actually overheat at this point in the game. They just won't produce any more power than can be cooled. Let's reinstall the radiators to take care of that problem. We added a lot of generators, so we're going to need a lot more radiator cooling power. You should have your two radiator bases that we removed, as well as a bunch of extensions. We're going to be using 36 total extensions, which should cover all of our heat even if we crank the generators to 100%. My test had heat at about 75% with the generator maxed out, so plenty of headroom. We'll use the hard points at the back of the ship to connect our radiators. Snap the radiator base to the hard point in the back corner of the ship and auto bolt it down. You can connect radiator extensions to each side of the base. Make sure the yellow side of the extension is always facing the base and keep rotating the extension pieces to make this wavy pattern all the way towards the front of the ship. You'll use 15 extensions going forward and one extension going towards the back of the ship on each base. You can auto bolt each extension, which will put the two required bolts in the radiator pieces, but I like to also put two bolts in the bottom of each wave like the original laborer module had, just to make sure it's secure, especially with a radiator this long. That should be enough getting our hands dirty for today. Who's ready to edit and write a little YOLOL? Our first task is to do a quick and easy modification to the generator script we wrote last episode. The concept is the exact same as it was before, but we're not going to need the generator to always be around 20% anymore. We'll also let the batteries drain to 50% before kicking in the generator instead of 80%. So with this modification, the generator will completely turn off once the batteries reach 100% and will only start up again once our batteries fall below 50%. Also, since it's all in one line, the generator will update every 0.2 seconds instead of every 0.4 seconds. Take a quick test drive and you'll be amazed at how much quicker the batteries jump back up to 100%. This extra power is going to be fantastic for some future power-hungry gadgets. You might notice in my test drive that our fuel rods are empty. It's actually just the original fuel rod. I'm going to replace that rod and then we'll write one more tiny YOLOL script so we can see all of our fuel at once. Get yourself a new basic YOLOL chip and stick it in one of the open sockets in the back of the ship. If you don't have any empty sockets, just move one of the scripts you're done working on to our racks up front. This code will be super simple. We're just going to set a network variable colon fuel rods to equal the sum of all five of our rods. We'll call them colon rod 1 through colon rod 5. You might notice after writing this code, the execution line keeps scrolling down the script even though we say go to 1 on the first line. That's because YOLOL can't find these field names anywhere. If YOLOL has any problems with a line of code, it will just skip the entire line and move on to the next one. We can solve this by first going to our dashboard and renaming our fuel chamber fuel screen to be fuel rods. Then we'll set the value of fuel chamber max fuel to be 1.5 million instead of 300,000, since we have 5 fuel rods and each has a max capacity of 300k. Now we just need to rename each of our fuel chambers fuel chamber fuel fields to be rod 1 through rod 5. If all went well, we can take a look at our dashboard again and we should see what all of our fuel rods contain now. That seems like a job well done. Thanks for watching. If you've been enjoying this series, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe so you don't miss the next one. If you want to see me experiment with these tweaks live on Twitch, I stream every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday. Link is down below if you want to follow me there. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you in the next one, but for now, please take it easy.